There are multiple ways to load a design into the FOF Creative icon for embroidery. When you turn your machine on, you can touch Start Embroidering, which will bring up a blank screen. If you've activated your My Sewnet account and you have items there, you can also touch Load from My Sewnet. So these are designs that are just kind of in my cloud. They're always on any machine I'm logged into, which is awesome. They kind of travel with me. And I can just go into any of these. So if I'm looking to do the designs from the Embroidery Essentials online course, I have them right here. Touch and hold, and these designs will show by their names or by their pictures. So if you're more of a visual person, you can select over here. If you have some designs that are very similar to each other and you need to know the difference, having the ability to see the actual title is key. So here's one way to kind of toggle between the two of those. So if you want to get a design, touch and hold, and then that design will come in on screen. Okay, so that's one way. Another way, I'm going to touch the home button here at the bottom. If we do just start embroidering, we'll find that we have ways to access the built-in designs, the built-in alphabet, also back to the My Sewnet with the cloud option here. So lots of ways to get to your designs. We can also come over to the main menu, the top right corner, where we will find our menus for each of the categories of designs. We can find them by groupings. If you touch any of the designs in this area just once, it will tell you what design it is, how big it is, how many colors, and even how many stitches are in that design. Once you have a design you want to use, you can easily touch load and it will also come into your embroidery screen ready to use. When you're ready to maybe make it disappear and pick a different design, remember touch and hold and it will come up with an option to delete it. And of course, delete is only taking it off the screen. It's not actually deleting it out of your machine completely. So a lot of times I do use the butterfly if I'm looking for some of my built-in designs where I can come in and find something that I want to work with. Again, once you touch and hold, it will come in. And if it's not where you want it, we're going to start by touching edit. And this will allow us to bring it into the center. Touch the center of the control wheel here, and that will bring it to the center of the hoop. This is where you can actually move it, rotate it, size it, mirror image it, duplicate it. So all these things are things we are going through all these videos. So do check out all the other videos. There's information in each of them that I get really excited about. Of course, the Embroidery Essentials online course is a great place to also master this machine through 15 different embroidery techniques. But after you have your design on screen, you will then tell the machine which hoop you will be using. You need to tell it this before you put the hoop on, before you touch go embroider, otherwise it's going to tell you to change hoops. So if you are using a different size hoop, pick that now, and whatever is green is the one that's active. Hoop options to close that. And when you're ready to stitch it out, go to embroidery stitch out. Let's just do that one next step. I'm not going to actually embroider this design out, but you do hear the embroidery arm moving into position. We get to this screen each time just to kind of confirm what you want to do with this design. Is the straight stitch needle plate on? Do you want your thread cutting options on or off? Do you want to baste around the hoop? Now, these are things that you can always come back and add or adjust once we get to the next screen, but you sure can do that right now. But once you're ready to embroider, touch OK, and then this is when you're going to put your hoop on and get ready to stitch. There's kind of two sides to the embroidery area, our stitch out screen and the embroidery edit. So each time you kind of want to go between where we were earlier and where we would embroider from, it's always in this lower left corner. So if you want to go to embroidery stitch out, you touch it. If you want to go come back to embroidery edit, then again, edit's where you would move it around or bring another design in or add lettering. That's all like setting up the design. But when you're ready to stitch it, touch embroidery stitch out and start embroidering. You can also get to designs by coming up here to the kind of help center and then pick designs via their techniques. So let's pick this yellow option, and we have options for garment techniques, sewing techniques, quilting techniques, and at the end, this is what people forget, embroidery techniques. So let me show you what this actually does. If you're looking for all the applique embroidery designs, you can select here. And let's just do the first one. They are divided up into different kinds of applique, like raw edge or reverse applique. But if I choose this first one, what it's going to do is actually find all the designs that are in this machine with the applique, with the traditional covered satin stitch edge. It's going to give me my tutorials, what I need to do this, but that's not all. FOF always has extra things in their machine, and the extra thing is right here, content. As you choose content, these are all the built-in designs that are set up for this particular technique. So instead of you looking through your book and trying to wonder which one is which, they're all right here for that specific technique. So if we come back to the help center, I'm going to just minimize this right here, and we were to look for cutwork embroidery, and how about just the normal one, cutwork with scissors versus cutwork with needles. I know, so many different ones. Touch and hold, and then choose content. Again, the instructions and the 8 built-in cutwork designs are right at your fingertips. Touch and hold to pick one, and then it's ready to stitch.